Hello students, today we are going to discuss about composite masonry. Basically, you have learned regarding stone masonry as well as brick masonry. Now we are talking about composite. Meaning of composite means it's a combination of two types of masonry or two types of material. So basically here you can see here this facing, it is with brickwork, while here this decking, it is with the stone masonry. So when such kind of combination, when we are adopting and just to have the good appearance on the facing side, generally it is called as composite masonry. So basically this composite masonry, it is, if you want to define, then when walls are constructed with two or more types of building materials or classes of masonry, then it is termed as composite masonry. So simply, it is the combination of two types of building material or two types of masonry. And generally this combination is brickwork with stonework or brickwork with concrete work. So these are the general composite masonries which are adopted, and these are the reasons why we are adopting on field for composite masonry. So first, it reduces the overall cost of construction, because facing side, if you want ki appearance acha hona chahiye, to hum wahan pe thoda zyada mehenga material use karenge, and inside you may use the inferior quality of the material. Okay, so it will overall cost reduction. It will be taken place if you are using such composite masonry. This will make the structure more durable by providing materials of better quality and good workmanship in facing side. So on the facing side, best quality material you are using, also good workmanship is applied, and more weathering actions that are generally observed on facing side. So you can say that the good durable structure can be obtained by using such type of composite masonry. It improves the appearance of the structure by concealing the inferior work. पीछे जो आपने प्रोवाइड किया बैकिंग में इंफीरियर वर्क प्रोवाइड किया, बट इट इज नॉट कमिंग ऑन द फ्रंट साइड. सो दैट्स व्हाई द अपीयरेंस वाइज द स्ट्रक्चर विल लुक गुड. ओके, एंड ऑल द इंफीरियर वर्क दैट यू आर कंसीलिंग बिहाइंड दैट. So that's why appearance wise it is also good, cost point of view, then strength point of view, durability point of view, this is considered to be better. It makes the use of locally available materials to obtain the optimum economy. Jo bhi locally available materials hai that you don't want to utilize on the facing side, that can be utilized on the back side, and by that you can bring overall economy to your structure. So you can utilize locally available material with the optimum economy. That is the reason. So these are the reasons, that will give you some advantage over simple your single masonry. So following are the usual combinations that are generally adopted for the composite masonry. So first is Aslar masonry facing with rubble masonry backing or brickwork backing. So generally Aslar masonry is considered to be good appearance on the front side. So that's why on the front side you can use Aslar masonry, on back side you can use rubble masonry or brick masonry. Then stone slab or tiles facing with concrete or brickwork on backing. Then brickwork facing with rubble masonry as backing. Then brickwork facing with cement concrete as backing. Or brickwork facing with hollow concrete, hollow cement concrete block at the back side. Okay, so you can say that on the front side, whatever kind of masonry that is giving good appearance and durability that you are providing on the front side, and the inferior quality or the one which is costly, that can you can utilize on the back side. Okay, so in small quantity you want to use that particular work on the back side. So here this first one is Aslar masonry facing with rubble masonry backing. So here you can see this is the facing side. So from the front elevation you can see it is the Aslar masonry. Okay, so that is giving good view or good appearance from the front side, but on the back side the rubble masonry is used. Okay, so that is not having that good appearance as Aslar masonry. So basically in this type of composite masonry, that composite rough tooled and chamfered stones are provided on the facing. So chamfered and tooled stones that you can provide on the front side, and rubble masonry on the back side. So as you know that rubble masonry is usually cheaper as compared to Aslar masonry. So this will bring good attractive appearance on the front side, that is of ester masonry. Ester masonry will give a attractive appearance. At the same time, due to use of rubble masonry on the back side, it will reduce the overall cost of your construction. So you can get the economy of rubble masonry and good appearance of ester masonry by combining both on front side and back side. Next is ester masonry facing with brickwork backing. So here on the facing side, again you are using ester masonry. So ester masonry is used, so that will give you good appearance. But on the back side, you are using brick masonry. So in this type of composite masonry, rough, tooled, and chamfered stones are provided in facing, and brickwork is provided in backing, as we have seen in this particular figure. So it is preferable to use the height of ester as a multiple of brick thickness. कि जो भी आपका ये हाइट है, हाइट ऑफ दिस एस्टर मेसनरी, इट शुड बी सच दैट इट इज इन द मल्टीपल ऑफ द ब्रिक थिकनेस, इन द मल्टीपल ऑफ द ब्रिक थिकनेस प्लस दिस पर्टिकुलर जॉइंट. सो टू हैव द प्रॉपर कोर्स अरेंजमेंट, अगर आपने प्रॉपर नहीं रखा जॉइंट, तो ये दैट विल बी प्रॉपर कोर्स अरेंजमेंट इज नॉट पॉसिबल इफ यू आर नॉट अरेंजिंग दिस ब्रिक वर्क ऑन द बैक साइड. सो दिस इट इज प्रिफरेबल दैट टू यूज द हाइट ऑफ द एस्लर एज अ मल्टीपल ऑफ ब्रिक थिकनेस प्लस मेसनरी जॉइंट्स टू ऑब्टेन द कोर्स्ड मेसनरी वर्क. सो कोर्स्ड मेसनरी वर्क इज वेरी एसेंशियल, दैट एज पर दिस हाइट ऑफ एस्लर मेसनरी यू हैव टू अरेंज योर bricks on the back side. An alternate course of ester is header. So basically this alternate course of particular ester masonry, it is consisting of headers. Okay, so this header brick should be used under such projecting course of ester. So jahan pe bhi ye projecting course hai, wahan pe aapko headers use karna hai ester masonry, that is on front side. Then stone slab or tiles facing with brick backing. So basically here in this figure you can see this is the facing side. So here stone slab or tiles are used, and on the back side brick masonry is used. So this is the combination of brickwork and stone slab on the front side. So the stone slab seldom exceed 5 to 10 cm in thickness. Uski thickness 5 se 10 cm se zyada nahi hoti, and they are properly secured to the brick backing, so you can effectively join them with this brick masonry on the back side. And it is desirable to use the metal clamps to connect properly facing and backing, because you are using two different materials here. So proper arrangement of connection between these two is very essential. So this should be done with the help of such type of cramp joint. Okay, so this kind of cramp that can be inserted, and with this lead or rich cement mortar, you can fill in this particular joint. Okay, and this stone used, whatever stone that you are using on the front side, it may be natural stone or artificial stone. So proper bonding between the two different materials, it is the essential requirement of composite masonry. So proper joint has to be established. So here in this case, you can utilize such kind of cramps with the pouring of lead or rich cement mortar to have the effective joint between stone as well as brickwork. Next is brickwork facing with rubble masonry backing. So here on the front side you are using brick masonry, and on the back side rubble masonry. So this is cheaper material or the cheaper kind of masonry, and brickwork for the good appearance it is used. So it's a basically, as the name suggests, bricks are used as facing material and rubble masonry are used as backing material. And this type of construction is adopted where rubble stones are available in large quantities. So all the backing that you can fill with the help of this cheap rubble stones, okay, and that will economize your construction. And at the same time, on the facing side, you are going to give good look with the help of the brick masonry. Next is brick facing with concrete backing. So here again on the front side you are using brick masonry, but on the back side you are using cement concrete. Okay, so this type of construction, bricks are used as facing material and concrete are used as backing material. So this type of construction is adopted to get the strength of concrete, as you know that this strength is very important criteria. So if you want that your structure should be very strong, so this cement concrete work can be utilized on the back side. But if you construct the whole wall with the help of cement concrete, then it will become very costly. Okay, so just to avoid that and to economize your construction and also at the same time you want your strong structure. So this cement concrete that you can utilize on the back side, and to bring the aesthetic on the front side, you can utilize your brick masonry on the facing side. So this combines the particularly good appearance of brick masonry, at the same time the strength and durability aspect of cement concrete, and at the same time you are trying to economize your construction with good appearance and durability point of view. The solid cement concrete wall, instead of this solid cement concrete block, you can replace this particular cement concrete wall with the cement concrete blocks also, and these blocks may be either solid or hollow blocks. So it's not like only the cement concrete wall you are continuously constructing on the back side. You can utilize the concrete blocks also, and that blocks can be arranged on the back side of brick masonry. So solid or hollow or solid blocks that can be utilized instead of this cement concrete wall. So there are certain precautions to be taken during the construction of composite masonry. So it is necessary to take the extreme care during composite masonry construction. Otherwise, unequal settlement is always possible due to large number of joints. Because you are combining two different materials, two different types of masonry, if proper jointing is not there, whenever load is coming, there are always chances ke ek type se wo settle ho jaye. So always there are chances that unequal settlement will take place, and due to large number of joints, if proper joint is not there, then unequal settlement will be always there. So what are the measures to be taken care, or what are the measures to be applied to avoid the large settlement? So first, using the large number of through stones for stone composite masonry. Whenever you are using stone composite masonry, large through stones. So large through stones can be provided after certain courses. So that will bring strength and durability to your structure. Here you can see this is the traditionally built wall with the stone masonry. Then this wall that is crumbling under the load. Okay. So to avoid that, in between, if you are putting very large stone, then it is called as the through stone. So use of this through stones that can be adopted whenever you are adopting one of the material as stone. So in stone composite masonry, this wide use of through stones after certain courses to be done, and so just to avoid the unequal settlement of your particular composite masonry. Then proper jointing is very important. So to provide that proper bonding, you have to provide metal cramps. So such kind of metal cramps that can be utilized to join the facing and backing, or use of such dovels. So in joint part of stone masonry, already we have discussed all these particular types of joints that are possible. Then lead plugs, etc., that can be utilized just to connect properly this facing and backing. So such use of proper jointing or the joints, it is very essential part of your composite masonry. Then construction of facing and backing with rich mortar. So you cannot use the inferior quality of mortar, and that will make your construction to be strong. So whatever mortar that are using, it should be rich mortar with the greater proportion of cement as compared to your fine aggregate. Then carry out the facing and backing proportions portions of the wall simultaneously. Aisa nahi ki facing bana diya fir backing mein bahut din laga rahe. Generally you have to carry out both the work of facing and backing simultaneously, and with proper bonding and proper jointing, you can bring the strength, durability as well as good appearance on the front side. So overall you can say there are following advantages that can be obtained if you are going for the composite masonry construction. So cost wise, the total cost is reduced because whatever available material, locally available material that you can utilize on the back side, and so maximum the optimum economy that can be obtained with the use of locally available material, and at the same time on the front side, whatever your preferable material to have the good appearance, that you can bring it on the front side. So on back side, locally available material can bring optimum economy. So that will reduce your cost. Next is durability. So possible to provide the better quality and good workmanship in the facing work so as to minimize the effect of atmospheric agent on the wall and durable structure can be obtained. So as you know that jo bhi aapka bahar ka side hoga facing side always there are chances weathering effects atmospheric agent rain hai wind hai everything that will act on front side. Okay, so if you are using durable material and better quality and good workmanship is applied on the front side, then you can construct a durable structure. And next one that is related to appearance. And as you are using good quality material on the front side with the good workmanship and that some ornamental factors view that you can give to your particular facing. So this appearance can be improved. So overall, you can say that by providing the composite masonry, you can minimize the cost and you can improve the appearance. At the same time, you can have the durable structure. So with this, I would like to finish my presentation that is on composite masonry. So thank you very much, all of you.